Hello and welcome to penetration testing in Linux YouTube channel. On this video, I continue to talk about Linux basic script. Most modern Unix Linux operating system provide a centralized packet management mechanism to help user search, install, and management software. The software is usually stored in the repository in the form of a packet. The UN management of the software packets is called packet management. The basic components of a Linux packet are shared library, application, server, and document. Packet management is usually not limited to one-time installation of software, but also include tools for operating install packet. The packet repository help ensure that the code has been reviewed on the system you are using and managed by the software developer or packet maintainer. When confined a Linux server or development environment, it is usually not limited to using official shop. Compared to the rapid update iteration of software version today, although the stable version of the official shop is likely to be outdated, it is a common scheme for system administrator and developer to master the basic operation of common Linux packet management. This video describes the basic way and quick reference for common Linux distribution, packet management for search, installation, and upgrade to help you quickly understand the basic operation and technique for different Linux packet management. Most packet management systems are collections built on packet file, which usually consist of compiled binary and other resources, software, installation script, metadata, and list of dependencies they need. While most popular Linux distributions are similar in packet management tool, method, and format, there are still platform different. Debian and its derivative such as Ubuntu, Linux Mint, and Raspbian are .deb file. APT is the most common package operation command, search library, installation packet and their dependency and management upgrade. The dpkg command is required to install the off-the-shelf .dab packet directly. CentOS, Fedora and Red Hat series lineup use rpm packet files and uem command to manage a packet file and interact with the software library. In the recent version of Fedora, the uem command have been replaced by dnf for packet management. Most Linux use a local database to store a list of remotely available packet repository, so it's a good idea to update this database for installing or upgrading packets. In the absence of packet management, upgrading and keeping Linux installed software in the latest version is a huge undertaking. undertaking. An administrator and user have to manually check upstream software version change and security warning. With the packet management system, you can keep your software up to date with just a few commands. Most Linux network versions provide an interface for users to search and install software packets, which is the best way to find and install software. But for efficiency and server administrator, using command line tool to find search for packet is the right way. Before deciding which packet to install, we often need to check the detailed description of the packet. The packet documentation usually includes metadata such as packet name, version number, and dependency list, which can be viewed using the following command. Once we know to the name of a packet, we can use the following command to install the packet. Many times we need to install the packet directly from local file system after testing and getting the packet directly from somewhere. Debian and derivative system can be installed using dpkg and CentOS and Fedora system are installed using the yum and dnf command. Finally, to remove an installed packet from Linux system, you can use the following command. Sadis, hope VL is useful for you. Please share my video to your friend. Thanks for watching. See you next time and bye bye.